The other day when I was at practicing again after today, you kind of read them the riot act a little bit. Was it just, what are you seeing that is kind of bothering you?
Well, no, I mean, there's always stuff to bother. I mean, I thought, you know, we've had good practices. Mm-hmm. But anything that sticks out, I'm going to point out. But I'm encouraged. I am encouraged. There's a lot of good things that are going on. We're trying to be smarter in our practices as opposed to coming out here for 3 hours and just, you know, rolling the ball out and scrimmaging. And, you know, we're trying to be more productive in what we do, mm-hmm. more situational things, things that we think will be more beneficial for us as a football team. So I'm encouraged. There's a lot of what we do in an hour and a half, 2 hours, has been way more productive than our normal Saturdays of rolling the ball out and scrimmaging for 3.5 hours.
How do you think Keenan's coming along? I know the other day you said he was kind of throwing the ball up a little bit too much, but do you feel like overall he's been pretty solid?
Human. I mean, mm-hmm. he makes some good throws and makes some things he needs to work on. Made some good decisions. More good decisions than bad, but he's still having, you know, he's human, makes some bad decisions. So the standard for him is pretty high.
Right.
But we're going to keep that ceiling up there. We're not going to lower it for him because we've seen what he could do. So good and bad. I mean, but he's having a solid scrimmage, I mean, spring, but he can always get better.
And you had said going into spring that you were going to wait to see how John Henrich developed before making a decision on Trey. I see that you're using Trey at slot back today. Has John shown you enough that you feel comfortable letting Trey work at slot?
Yeah, John's actually had a real good spring. Mm-hmm. Really encouraged by John. So really feel very good about him being our backup quarterback. And so he's solid, you know, as our backup quarterback. We've moved Trey now to A-back. Trey will probably, you know, we'll see some of our younger guys that are here, some of the younger guys that are coming from NAPS to kind of battle for that third spot, and we'll see how that goes. If we feel good about one of those guys being a solid third, you know, Trey's days at quarterback will be completely over. If not, he'll be the emergency guy.
All right. Now, offensive line, I was taking a look at who was working kind of with the first unit. I mean, I know that you had two guys already out for the spring, and now is Braden Heap not practicing either?
Yeah, we're just being careful. I mean, it's spring ball.
Right.
You know, I mean, just, you know, if we probably push came to shove, you probably could tape it up, and mm-hmm. he'd probably limp around. But, you know, he's not completely ready, so we just want to make sure we're smart. You know, but without Graham, Tanner Fleming's not going either.
Mm-hmm.
So four of our starting linemen aren't there, but it's been great work for us.
Right. I mean, you're impressed with some of these younger guys?
Very impressed with Chris Northern. We just moved from Northern. We just moved from defensive end. He's having a great spring. Joey Gaston at one tackle is doing well. E.K. Benz, a young guy that we're counting out to be our left guard, had a solid spring. Ben Tamburello.
Yeah, so he moved from center out to guard, right?
He's been really solid. Blaze Ryder and Brandon Green at center.
Right.
You know, those are some guys. So it's, you know, you always want to make sure you have less red than white or blue, but I'm encouraged because the guys that are in there are getting good reps.
And I also noticed you moved two of your nose guards, Ike and Doolittle, over to offensive line. Do you think they might be able to help you over there?
Hopefully. They're, you know, work in progress. They just got there. But we feel really good about our other nose guards, you know, with Barry and Travis, Bernie, and obviously, you know, we don't even have Dan Ring there, so.
Right. You got a lot of nose guards.
Yeah, so we just wanted to kind of, we feel good about our physical pieces. I'm super encouraged by who we have at a lot of different positions. I feel really good about our inside linebackers, our outside linebackers, our slot backs. We just got to keep working. Just got to keep our head down and keep grinding.
Another guy that I noticed today who did some things, Greg Bryant, moved out to wide receiver, and it looks like he could be a player there.
Yeah, he's got some size. He's got some speed. He's a good athlete, so very excited for Greg Bryant. You know, he's kept his mouth quiet. He's worked hard, and so super encouraging.
Any other young kids that maybe didn't play much last year that have shown you something?
There's a lot of guys. Off the top of my head, I think of Colin Osborne.
You know, mm-hmm. He had a couple good runs.
You know, he's done some good things. There's a lot of guys working hard.
Is Swain pushing Copeland?
Swain has been phenomenal. He's had a phenomenal spring.
Right.
The guy that we got to find a spot for, they were really encouraged about. But, you know, we moved two guys into inside linebacker, Micah Polamalu. Mm-hmm. Jimmy Britt looked really good, and William Anthony looks really good. So all those guys look good. And we just got to keep working.
All right. Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.